Welcome back to my channel, guys, at Trey Fragrances, and I'm back with another banger. So if you guys are new to the channel, make sure you guys like, comment, and subscribe, and turn on your post notifications because I will be posting more content for you guys. So in this vid, I will be talking about my five least fragrances in my collection. Which, you know, these fragrances are still good. You know, in my opinion, I think these fragrances are still good. But, you know, these are the ones, you know, I really, you know, kind of fell back on. So, without further ado, let's get straight into this video. Now, this first fragrance that I really fell back on is one of my least favorites in my collection is Kamara Latafa. This fragrance to me is good, but to me it's overly too sweet. You know, you get that sweet cinnamon right off the bat, sweet cinnamon, ambery. You know, it really just too sweet, and I really just can't cope with it. I wear this fragrance one time, I promise you. I wear this fragrance one time. I did not like it. It was too sweet. Only sprayed like two sprays with this, and the projection is good. The longevity is real good. I like those things in that, you know, perspective in that area, but the scent is just the sweetness is overclouding with sweetness. I just really can't deal with it. You know, that cinnamon is really just too strong. You know what I mean? So Kamara Latafa is too sweet in my opinion, but a lot of people love this fragrance, you know. To me, this like a love or hate fragrance. You either love it or you don't. And with me, I really don't love it. So, yeah. So this next fragrance we have is Azzaro, the Most Wanted Eau de Parfum. And y'all, this is the Eau de Parfum. That's what it is, the Eau de Parfum. I said the Eau de Parfum. Sorry about that, guys. The Eau de Parfum. This is the Azzaro Wanted. This is the silver bottle. This one is more of a freshness. Got that vetiver, but it's still, you know, like a give like a touch of a sensual, you know, scent. And it's definitely sensual, you know. But to me, this is the worst one they made. Now I haven't tried the new one that they came out with, the newest Azzaro, but I've smelled all of them, and this is my least favorite. My first favorite in the Azzaro line is the Azzaro the Most Wanted Parfum, and then the Azzaro the Most Wanted Intense, then this. And like literally this fragrance, I've wear this maybe a couple of times. I did get compliments on it now, but me personally, I really didn't like it. You know, I'm put like this. When I first got it, I liked it, but now it's like, I don't know. I'm kind of growing out of it. And this scent just, it's like, I don't know. It's like a plum vetiver. Something like you can just definitely get that in the scent, but you know, it smells good. Like I say, this is the second least favorite, you know, in my collection. So I mean, but guys, to me it still smells good. So if you want to pick this up, hey, go pick it up. Make sure you try a sample first if you're debating on getting the full bottle. Now this next fragrance we have is the Raj Pour Homme. So this scent is like a you get a floralness in this scent. And let's see. Make sure I didn't get it. Okay. All right. See, me, it's one, it come off too strong. I really don't like it. Like, I like it, but it's just like I say, it's my least favorite. But this scent is really not all that, to be honest. And it's you kind of get like a fruitiness that's in this fragrance. You do get that fruitiness in there. You kind of like get like a watermelon, you know, somewhere up around there in that area, like a watermelon note. And this scent is just, it's good. But it doesn't blow me away. It doesn't surprise me with any. It doesn't have, like, to me, any uniqueness to this fragrance. But like I say, other than that, the fragrance is still good. You know, the scent is good. So if you're looking for, you know, this fragrance, you know, I'm not gonna lie, I do recommend y'all picking this up. But I know some people might not like it, so. Just get the sample. Me personally, I still like it, but I rarely wear this. Literally, like I rarely wear this fragrance. But guys, pick this up. You know, like I say, just get the sample before you buy it. Now, this next fragrance is one of my least favorite, is Bentley for Men Azure. This is a car manufacturer fragrance. You get that bergamot. You get like a lemon. You get that citrusy. And it's just, it really tops off. Now, I'm not gonna lie, you kind of get a little woodsy note. You get those woodsy notes down in the dry down. And so, but I can say that this scent, it smells, it doesn't smell, you know, what can I call it? It doesn't smell too surprising, you know what I mean? Like it's a good freshie, you know what I mean? It's like a good everyday occasional scent, but it just don't, you know, really. This fragrance doesn't make me want to wear it that often. I'm gonna put it like that. But the fragrance is still good. It's Bentley Azure for Men, good freshie, you know. Great woodsy notes, affordable fragrance. So, do I recommend y'all getting this? I'm not gonna lie. Yes, I do recommend y'all getting this fragrance. Y'all just want a great, affordable, cheapy, you know, fragrance. Hey, pick this up, Bentley Azure for Men. They do have more fragrances, which I will be looking into that. So, now, last but not least, we have Burberry Hero. Eau de Parfum. This scent, lot of that benzoin note. You get that woodsy note in this fragrance. It's kind of like a bougie scent, great fall scent. I can say that, you know, good for those colder seasons. This scent, I know a lot of people was trying to get me on the Eau de Toilette, you know, the basically like the lighter version of this one, but this one is more like of a dark, sensual, woodsy, you know, benzoin scent. It's definitely a mature smell, a man scent, you know. So yeah, this scent is really it. This I would say this scent is good. But I feel like the Eau de Toilette might be better. Like, I feel like the Eau de Toilette might be better than the Eau de Parfum. Like, I don't know. This scent, it's too much of that benzoin note. It kind of throws me off a little bit, you know. But like I say, the scent is still good. So yeah, guys, if you want to get this, pick it up. Do I recommend you getting it? Yes, I do. But to me, like you can see from the bottle, I barely wear this. It's still full. You might as well say that it's still full. I only wear this a couple times. But yeah, this scent, you know, it's good, but it really just kind of strong after the initial spray of that benzoin. You get that woodsy note, and it's just too much a little bit. So guys, ladies and gentlemen, I hope you enjoyed this video of these five least favorites in my collection. And like I say, none of these fragrances are bad. I do recommend y'all getting these fragrances. Now, Latafa, I don't know, because I really don't like that fragrance at all. I'm not even going to sugarcoat to y'all. I really don't like that fragrance at all. Too overly sweet, you know, but yeah. All right. But yeah, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And I hope every last one of y'all are feeling good, looking good, dressing good, and most importantly about smelling good. And I hope y'all have a blessed day. And it's your boy, Trey Fragrance. And I will see y'all in the next video.